Ouch, that's gonna hurt for a while. Things seem a little fuzzy. I think I'm hearing things too. Hey, was something over there? Look, there it is. But I can't see its face. Boy, he sure is relaxed. Oh no, there it goes. Let's follow him. I say it's time to find out what kind of animal we have here. This animal is called the Siamang ape. Wow, he's cool looking. It's important to know that the Siamang is a type of ape and not a monkey. Do you know how to tell the difference between an ape and a monkey? Well, the easiest way to tell the difference is to look for a tail. You see, a monkey has a tail and an ape doesn't. How convenient is that? Siamangs have most of their bodies covered in long, dense black hair. One place they don't have much hair is on their faces. See? Just a slight mustache and beard to go along with their dark eyes and smallish noses. Siamangs are hylobates, which means dweller in the trees. So, if you want to find a Siamang when in its natural environment, look up! Standing about 3 feet tall with a slender body, the Siamang has incredibly long arms. In fact, its arms are longer than its legs. With arms that long, the Siamang could wear 2 watches. Or maybe 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Well, that's just plain silly. Siamangs are extremely acrobatic because they live in trees. They use their long arms as transportation by swinging gracefully from branches and vines. This is called brachiating. That looks fun. Let's try some brachiating, shall we? Whoa, that's tougher than it looks. How do Siamangs do it? Oh, I see how they do it. If you look closely at their hands, you'll see the answer. They don't grab the vine with their fingers and thumbs like you and I do. They use the 4 fingers on their hands to hook onto vines and branches, allowing them to safely swing up to 30 feet in distance. Oh, would you look at that? I guess Siamangs like to use their fingers for something other than hanging on branches, like keeping their hair all nice and dapper. I guess it's important to look your best when swinging through the forest canopy. Are you finished, Mr. Siamang? What was that? I must be hearing things. Well, there it is again. And again. Is that the Siamang? It is. Wow, look at its throat. It's expanding like a piece of blown bubblegum. Now, Siamangs are often called singing Siamangs because of their loud vocal calls. Some calls warn other Siamangs to stay out of their territory, while other calls help communicate between family groups. All this singing usually begins in the morning and can be heard up to 3 miles away, thanks to their large throat sacs. The throat sac inflates to about the size of a Siamang's head. When the throat sac expands, it gives the vocal cords extra power, making the calls even louder. Both males and females have a throat sac, but each one makes a different sounding call. The female alternates barks and booms. The male has a high-pitched scream. This singing can last up to 30 minutes and usually ends with the thunderous boom of the male. Oh, the humanity. Ugh, Once again, that's gonna hurt for a while.